This lab demonstrates how easy it is to perform calculations with PI DataLink. As usual, we have a completed solution for you in the C drive, labs, client tools, perform a calculation in PI DataLink solution folder. The production report solution is a file that contains the template with all of the calculations already performed for you to review in executive mode. So let's go ahead and start with a template. If we go to the folder right next to it, workspace, we have the production report template, which contains the same template, but is empty. This is a production report of a shift that started yesterday at 11 p.m. and it ended this morning at 7 a.m. We want to calculate production totals, averages, standard deviations, minimums and maximums for the shift. The production total is reflected in this tag, CDT158, and later, in the second part of the lab, we are going to also perform hourly calculations. That's why we have this time interval here of 1 hour. The units we are working with are gallons per minute. So let's go ahead and perform the production total. If I go to the PI menu, click on calculated data, that will open my dialog window. I can choose the PI server name, or if I leave this blank, PI DataLink will select the default server, the default PI server. The tag name is the one on cell B3. The start time is on cell B4, 11 p.m. last night. The end time is on cell B5, 7 a.m. this morning. I do not need a time interval because I am calculating the total for the entire shift, and I do not need a filter expression. But because I am doing a total calculation, I do need a conversion factor. The PI server assumes in the total calculation that the units are units per day, or in this case, gallons per day. So I need a conversion factor of minutes to days, and that's 1,440 minutes in a day. The output cell is going to be cell B16, and I can go ahead and click apply, and I have my total production for the shift, 51,540 gallons. Following a similar procedure, I can go ahead and calculate now the average gallons per minute during that shift. I keep the same tag name, the same start and end time. I do not need a conversion factor because that only applies to the total calculation. I select average, and I select the output cell of C16. Verify, make sure that I have all the correct input parameters, and click apply. The average was 107 gallons per minute. Following the same process, I can calculate the standard deviation, minimum and maximum. All I need to change in each one of those cases is the calculation mode, standard deviation, and the output cell, D16. Click apply, and the standard deviation was 30 gallons. The minimum, going to cell E16, was 52 gallons. And the maximum, going to cell F16, was 168 gallons. At last, I want to calculate the range of my values. And also, I want to include in that calculation the percent of good values, so I can ensure that the data that I'm using is accurate. So I keep the same start and end time. I'm going to select range from the calculation mode. The output cell is going to be G16, and I want to check the show percent good box. I click apply, and I can see that the range changed or vary over 115 gallons, and 100% of the data or the points were good, as demonstrated in cell H16. I am now ready for the second part of the lab, which is the hourly calculations, and this is where the hourly time interval will come into place. The tag name will remain the same, the start and end time will remain the same, but now I can select my 1 hour time interval from cell B7. In addition to that, I want to again use the conversion factor of 1440 to calculate the total production or total hourly production in each one of those hours. The output cell is going to be cell A20, and I do not want to show the percent good. I'm going to review my input parameters, make sure that everything is okay, and I can go ahead and click apply. Oops! One thing that I wanted to do was include the start time, show start time as a timestamp. So let's check that box and click apply again, and now I have my timestamp on the correct column and the production totals, the hourly production totals in column B. I can now calculate the average hourly production, and I can do that by maintaining the same start and end time, the same time interval of 1 hour. I do not need the conversion factor, that's only for total productions. I can go ahead and select average, and I do not want to show the start time. Let's go ahead and change the output cell to cell C20 and click apply, and I have my average hourly production. Following the same procedure, I can do the same for a standard deviation, minimum and maximum. All that requires is for me to change the type of calculation and the output cell to cell D20, click apply. I do the same for minimum, change the output cell to cell E20, click apply, and I can see how this array of numbers is being created, and how many numbers I have in here will totally depend on my start, end time, and the time interval that I choose. And one last one, I want maximum, output cell, cell F20, click apply. And the last hourly values that I want are the range, or the range of values for each one of those hourly intervals, and again for each one of them I want to know how many of those values were good. And since I know that all of them were good for the shift, these numbers should be 100% good for each one of the intervals. So let's go ahead and select range. The output cell is going to be C20, and I want to check the show the start time for a rather show the percent good to see how many values were good during those intervals. I click apply, and as expected, I have my ranges of values, and I have all of the numbers 100% good.